It's the scourge of Zika, babies born with a devastating birth defect called microcephaly. And now Zulmaris Molina is about to find out if her baby might have it too. Molina, who lives in Puerto Rico, contracted the Zika virus early in her pregnancy. She's now 22 weeks along, a little more than halfway through her pregnancy.
Tell me what you know about your baby already.
Their name is gonna be Micaela.
So you know it's a girl?
Yeah.
If your baby has these problems, it will be more difficult.
Definitely, because I have already a baby boy, and I'm a single mother. And it's gonna be really difficult.
Tomorrow morning, you're gonna have another ultrasound.
Yes.
How are you gonna feel tomorrow if he says, wait a minute, I see something going on in the brain?
Nobody wants to hear that. Even when you are prepared, and you're trying to be prepared for that. So I know I'm gonna be sad.
She goes in for her ultrasound the next day with Dr. Alberto de la Vega at University Hospital in San Juan.
You see a hand right there with all the five fingers? That's your kid's face. Who does she look like?
Yeah. She looks like my little boy.
At first, everything looks fine. But then Dr. de la Vega measures the baby's head. It's growing, but at a slower pace than expected.
You see that there's a slight lag in the growth. This is what we would expect. And it's still within the normal range, but it's lagging behind. That, obviously, in this situation, is a cause of concern. Although the anatomy still looks great, I would like to see you more frequently.
When babies have had severe brain abnormalities, some mothers who've had Zika have chosen to terminate their pregnancies.
Hearing this, hearing about the lag in growth, how does that make you feel?
Well, it gives me a little bit of concern, you know, worry. This baby is going to be born. So no matter what happens, I'm going to have the baby.